Welcome to Tasker 101 Tutorials. This is lesson 27B. This is just kind of a little bit extra, sort of a throwaway lesson, if you will, on a couple of tricks and ways you can implement the Android L material design into your scenes. So we're going to use the scene that we created in lesson 27, hence the reason this is lesson 27B. And we gave it a little bit of a material design by just very simple square with a very solid vivid color at the top, very simple text, and then the actual reminder was here. And so this is just a couple of tricks you can do to, if you want to give it a little bit more of a material design feel to it. What I'm going to do is first I'm going to make this a little bit smaller. I don't think I'm going to have many, don't want to be that small. I'm not going to have many Google Now reminders that have text that wouldn't fit in that box there. I can probably go down a little bit more. Let's use the, that's probably good. Yeah, my reminders aren't that long, so that's going to be good for that. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a couple of elements to give it that perspective. First, I'm going to choose oval. Even though it says oval, it can actually be a circle. For geometry, let's take it, let's do 185 by 185. And then color-wise, we're going to have it be like a gray. We're going to have it be a gray you can kind of see through. Change the alpha level. And let's take it down. There we go. Okay, it's probably bigger than I want it to be. Let's just make it a little bit smaller. Let's go 150 by 150. Yeah, that's probably good. And I'm gonna kind of move down the corner there. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm going to add another one. Now this one I'm going to make 147 by 147. Whoa. That's not at all what I did. By 147. Sometimes, for some reason, in scenes, it just doesn't take your values. So you have to go back and do it again. Alright, so let's take this one. We're going to put it on top of that one. Let's tap that. Now, what we want to do, we want to make that exactly the same color as the top here. So let's tap the top, let's go over to background, copy that color, and then tap this, and in color, we'll paste. That way we know it's exactly the same. And if you look at this, you'll see there's a little bit of a gray border. Kind of helps that button stand out a little bit. I think both of those need to be a little bit smaller. Let's go to normal. Ooh, that was not what I wanted to do. I just made my box smaller. That happens. When that happens, you just have to fix it. Not too difficult to do. Let's move this down here. And let's move that. Let's just go ahead and resize. Well, let's see. Yeah, I'm going to resize them just a little bit. So, Actually, I'm going to move that over so I can tap it easy enough. Normal. So let's tap that circle and let's make it 149 by 149. See if that took. Yep. And then this one, we're going to make 145 by 145. And now let's move that up just a little bit. And you'll see, it gives it a little bit of that, the circle in the bottom. Probably make those smaller. That's what I would probably do. Let's see, let's make, go back to normal. Of course, if you're getting bored, you can fast forward through this. Some people like to see exactly how it's done. Other people just want the gist of it. You can fast forward to the part where I'm actually done. This, let's go 143 and 143. So that's kind of it. I would probably work with this a little bit more. I don't like how close it is to the corner. So I might change that a little bit or make that a little bigger. But you kind of get the gist of what's going on. And then what I would do is I would add text. I would make this a capital X. I would make it probably 35. Text color should be white. Yep. Go back. And then resize the box. Whoa, not what I wanted to do. Resize the box. And then move it. So that's right in the center of that. And how you can figure out exactly where it is if you go to normal and you tap anything, you can see second two numbers of geometry, as you've seen, are the size, and the first two numbers are where the center, where it's located. So this is at 517 461. So let's move this to 517 and 461. And I'm going to move this to 517 and 461. Somehow that does not look exactly right, but I can probably play with it a little bit and get it more where I want it to be. Yeah, I would play with that some more and get that more exact. I'll do that and show it to you in a minute, just to show you another thing I would do. Click the plus, go to image, go to built-in icon, And Tasker has these built-in Android icons that you can use. And there's that little back arrow, which has become now sort of infamous in Android material design. Sometimes when you have a lot of stuff, it's impossible to move stuff correctly. So, size. So you can see you have a little arrow now. So you have a little arrow that you generally have. If you wanted to, you can make Google Now Reminder a little smaller, might be a little bit more in line. You don't want to play with this. Ultimately, you want to make sure that you get it so that it's centered, and so that your two circles and your X both have the same center point. Right now, they obviously do not. Let's see. Move that over. And then... tap that 528 472. That looks a little bit better. Again, I'm kind of picky, I'd probably work on a little bit more, but you can see you have just a tiny bit of the gray from the under circle, so that it makes that circle stand off a little bit more, which is material design. Buttons are supposed to look like buttons. Now, what else I would do, I would go back and assign these different things. So I would probably assign a tap on here, and I just resized it, but I would assign a tap on the X to be destroy scene. I would assign a tap on the arrow to maybe open up Google Now. And you should know how to do all that because we've done all that before. But that way, I've given it a little bit more of that material design before I screwed up the size 2 seconds ago, and also added more functionality to my scene so that now I can dismiss the scene, the reminder, or I can open Google Now to go into Google Now and see my other reminders, or you could make this go to your calendar if you wanted it to go to your calendar, whatever you wanted to do. But yeah, that's kind of how you would do it. So anyway, that's it for this lesson. If you like this lesson, please click that like button. You know, anyone who's interested in all this kind of stuff, then let them know. You know, it's just kind of a way for people who aren't necessarily designers, don't have Photoshop, et cetera, but want to kind of do some material design things with Tasker and scenes to be able to do it. So please share this with anyone you know who might be interested. Check out the playlist, subscribe to the channel, all that fun stuff. Check out HollywoodPhoto.com when you get a chance. And feel free to drop a message in the comments below if you'd like. Anyway, that is it. Until next time, so have fun with Tasker.